In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create the big architect's cactus towers in Revit. Well, we're just going to be creating one cactus tower and then you can copy it if you want. Now we're going to be starting off by creating this really weird shape that we're actually going to be using to generate all of the floors for our building. And then I'm going to be showing you how to create the walls and how to cut them out or carve them out in order to get the final shape. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to be linking it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, this is definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. As you can see, I have already placed some levels. So we have 19 levels. And then also in level one, you can see the floor plan that we're going to be using to model this building. So we're going to be starting off by going to Massing Insight, turn on Show Mass, and then go to In Place Mass. We can call it Mass 1. Just click OK, and there we go. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're just going to pick the inscribed polygon and we're going to set the sides to 16. So we need 16 sides, go from the center and then just go outside to the edge of the building, let's say something like this, click and there we go. Hit the escape key a few times, go to the 3D view, select this shape, go to create form, and it's going to create an extrusion, which you can just extend all the way to the final level. Now let's go back into level one, and I just want to create this rectangle, and I just want to follow the edges here. So let's go to line, and then create one line like that, one horizontal line like that, one vertical line here, and another vertical line there. And now I'm just going to be using the trim and extend to corner to fix all of these up just like that. Okay, so once we have all of this in place, now it's time to copy this all the way up and just rotate some of these profiles in order to give us the shape. So let's select this one first, and then I'm just going to go here to the clipboard, go to copy to clipboard, go to paste, and then go to align to selected levels. Here, I'm just going to pick level 2 and level 3. Click OK, just like that. Then I'm going to select the level 2 one, and you don't have to zoom in to see which level this is on. What you can do is simply select one of the rectangles, and here in the properties, it's going to display which level this is on. So I want this one, and then I want to rotate that by using the rotate tool. I don't need to change the center of rotation, I just need to add the angle of 22.5. You want to uncheck copy and hit enter, and now it's just going to rotate that. Okay, so now moving forward, we want to select the level 3 and then go to copy to clipboard, paste, align the selected levels, and let's pick level 4. Click OK. And now this one I'm also going to rotate by the angle of, in this case, minus 22.5, just like this. Then I'm going to copy this one to clipboard, go to paste, align to selected levels, and pick out level 5, and then click OK. And now this one is going to be rotated again by the value of minus 22.5. Okay, so now we have all of our main shapes, and now it's just a matter of copying this up along the height of this tower. Now you can use the image as reference and then just view that. In this case, I have just written this down, so I'm just going to be using that, and you can just follow the numbers that they say here. So the next step is going to be to select level 3, which is this one. Yeah, level 3. So level 3 is going to be copied and paste it along, aligned to selected levels. And here I'm going to first select level 7, hold the control key to add multiple levels, and then let's go with 13, 17, and 19. So holding the control key all the way as I select that, click OK, and now as you can see, it has copied these levels. Then I want to copy level 2, which is this one, yes. Go to copy, paste, align to selected levels, and here we should go to 8, hold the control key, 12, 14, and 18. Click OK, we have that one. Moving forward, we have number 4, which is this one. Yeah, that one. Go to copy to clipboard, paste, align to selected levels. And this one, number 4, goes to 6, hold the control key, 10, and also 16. Click OK. And finally, we have level 5, which is this one. Yeah, it's that one. So level 5 goes to copy to clipboard, paste, align to selected levels, and this one goes to 9, hold the control key, 11 and 15. Click OK. And now if we can orbit around, we can see that we have the correct shape in place. So having created this, the next step is just to make a big cross selection, grab everything, go to filter, and you want to uncheck form and hit apply. Okay, so now basically the cylinder or the extrusion is left out. So we just have the profiles, and you go to create form, which is going to give us this really, really weird form that we can use to generate our first mass floors and then actual floors. So we just want to go here to finish mass. What I'll do is I'm just going to save this shape. So I'll select it, go to copy to clipboard, paste, align to the same place. So essentially we have duplicated this shape. So you just want to go here to hide in view and just hide this element. So basically we have hidden the copied element. Now I'm just going to select this one, go to edit in place, and here I just want to select the cylinder or the extrusion. So hover over it, hit the tab key once to highlight the entire thing, click to select and hit delete. Okay, so once we have the shape just there, hit finish. And now it's time to turn on mass floors. So you select it, you go to mass floors, and then you select the first level, go down to 19, hold the shift key, click on the last one. So you basically select everything, and then you click any one of these checkboxes, and it's going to check all of them. Click OK, and it's going to generate all of those mass floors, just like that. The next step is to turn this into actual floors. So for that, let's go here to mass insight, go to floor, and then let's switch to 300 millimeter and highlight all of them like this and go to create floor. And now we have the floors. Just to make this a bit easier to see, let's go and change the graphic display options to include some shadows and set the lighting like that. Apply. Okay, perfect. Okay, so here we have done a lot. We still have the top missing. So the top is not going to be generated as a floor. It needs to be a roof. So you just go here to roof and you pick that face, create roof, done. Okay, now hit the escape key a couple of times, and now it's time to create our walls. To create the walls, first we need to get rid of this shape because we don't really need it anymore. So just hit delete and we just have the floors. So next, go to reveal hidden elements, which is here, select this shape and go to unhide element, and then exit out of this mode, select this shape, go into edit in place. And here we just want to select the weird, awkward shape. So let's hover over it, hit the tab key once, it's going to highlight everything, click to select and then hit delete. So now we're left with just the cylinder in place. Perfect. So now let's generate the walls. So the walls are going to be mass walls, just a mass shape. So let's go to level 1, go to lines, and then I'm just going to create a line going from one side to the other of this existing rectangle on the bottom. So it's just following the floor, and you just want to make sure it's going through the center, and it is. Then let's go here to offset. OF is the shortcut. Offset should be 150 millimeters, and you can keep copy on and then just offset this like so. Hit the escape key a couple of times, select the middle one and hit delete, and then just use simple lines to cap it at both ends, just like so. Okay, so once we have this, we need to select the rectangle. Go to the 3D view. Yeah, the rectangle has been selected. Then you just go to create form and you need to stretch it out all the way to the top, just like that. Let's go back into level 1, and then here we need to select the entire form. So you hover over it, hit the tab key once, and it's going to say form element. Now you click. So you want to make sure it's in the entire form, not just the lines on the bottom. So once this is selected, you then go to rotate. RO is the shortcut, and then let's go and make sure that copy is now selected, and the angle is 22.5. The center of rotation should be in the middle by default, and it is, which is perfect, and then you just hit enter. There we go. Then you just repeat that numerous times until you complete the whole rotation, because the array doesn't work in massing. And there we go. So now we have our walls all modeled out. Now they shouldn't go through the center. So let's fix that with a void. So it's just going to be another inscribed polygon going from the center all the way out like so. Hit the escape key a couple of times, select that shape, go to 3D, go to create form, open up the drop menu and pick void form. And now we just need to extend it all the way up like so. Okay, now we need to delete the cylinder because we no longer need it. So you hover over it, you hit the tab key, it's going to select it. But when you want to delete it, as you can see, it's grayed out. You cannot delete it. The reason is it's being cut by that void. And when it's being cut by the void, it doesn't let you delete it for some reason. So we just need to uncut it. So go to cut, drop menu, uncut geometry, select this, the extrusion, select the void. There we go. So it's still cutting the walls, just not the extrusion. So now we can hover over the extrusion, hit the tab key once to select the form element, click to select and hit delete. And there we go. It's gone. Okay. Now we just need to hit finish mass just like this. And now we need to cut the mass with all of these floors. So you just go here to cut geometry, click on the mass and make sure that multiple cut is checked on. You click on the mass and then you just need to click on all of the floors. So just like this, and as you can see, it's cutting all walls simultaneously at once, which is great. So we're just going to go all the way to the top and cut it there as well. Hit the escape key a couple of times. There we go. Now, finally, we just need to cut out the shape of the cactus, of the little cactus needles. So you do that by creating another in-place mass, which is just going to be a void. So let me show you. So you just go here to in-place mass, create a new mass. Now I'm just going to click on show mass just to make sure that it's the correct one, and it is. Then you go to line, make sure that the draw on work plane is selected, and you just start drawing. So I'm just going to go from this edge here. Then you find this endpoint. So basically you just snap on the endpoints and you just go all the way to the top. So it is a little bit tedious. So you just basically continue clicking like this until you get to the very top. Now, once we get to the top, you just want to follow the outline of this shape all the way down and just finish it here where we've started. Okay, perfect. So once we have this, hit the escape key a couple of times, then you want to select this line and kind of counterintuitively, instead of a void, you just want to create this as a solid form. So the reason we're doing this is because this is a secondary mass and it needs to be a solid mass so we can save it and then we can use it to cut the original mass. If that doesn't make sense, don't worry, it will in a few moments. So I'm just going to turn this the other way around, there we go, and just attach it to the other edge of this wall. Is it there? I think it is. Okay, there we go, perfect. So once we have this in place, I can just hit finish mass, there we go. And now I'm simply going to go to cut geometry, select this original mass and cut it with the new mass. Now the new mass will still stay there, but we can select it and then we can hide it. And now we have that perfect cactus wall. And we simply need to repeat this so we can get the final shape, which looks like this. And it's actually pretty amazing. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.